Distinguished delegates, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to begin my statement by expressing my gratitude to you all for honoring the Kingdom of Morocco and appointing our ambassador, or electing our ambassador, to chair the 22nd session of the Conference of States Parties of the CWC. My gratitude also goes out to the African group for having placed their trust in my country and giving our ambassador, His Excellency Mr. Palouki, the opportunity to chair over these proceedings. I would also like to pay tribute to the outgoing chairperson, the ambassador of Germany, who did a stellar job in the chair during the 21st session of the Conference of the States Parties. I would also like to fully endorse the statements delivered by His Excellency Ambassador Vusi-Bruce-Koloani, the permanent representative of South Africa, and the interim coordinator of the African group, as well as that read out by Madame Haifa Sami-Meta, the ambassador and permanent representative of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela on behalf of the non-aligned movement in China. I would also like to express my gratitude to His Excellency Ambassador Ahmed Uzunchu, the Director General of the organization. I greatly appreciate his opening address, and I would like to pay tribute to the efforts that he's deployed at the head of the organization. His leadership has enabled the OPCW to be awarded the Nobel Peace Prize, a most deserved distinction. It's also very pleased to see that we are now reaching the end of the total destruction of all declared chemical weapons stockpiles. We are also pleased to welcome, as our new Director General, His Excellency Ambassador Fernando Arias, the permanent representative of Spain. My country will certainly work alongside the new Director General with the same willingness and support that we've demonstrated hitherto. Mr. Chairman, my country strongly condemns the use of chemical weapons by anyone under any circumstances at any time. This flies in the face of the Convention as well as the decisions of the Executive Council and the UN Security Council, as well as the relevant provisions of international law. We are very pleased to see the fourth phase of strengthening the cooperation with Africa. This program is what will enable African states to achieve their aspirations for inclusive and sustainable development. We greatly appreciate the dynamism of the TS and in particular the Assistance and Protection Services. They've been working tirelessly to foster and strengthen national and regional capacity. There's no denying that its assistance makes it possible for African states parties to develop adequate protection measures against chemical attacks and chemical threats. In 2018, my country will have the honor of hosting the Regional Conference of National Authorities from the African States Parties. And we believe that this event will make it possible for us to strengthen African priorities in this area. Through its cooperation and assistance programs, the OPCW has given greater motivation to African States Parties. They've benefited from these events and also make it easier for them to achieve their obligations under the Convention. We are pleased with the progress made in destruction, especially with the chemical weapons in Libya. We also would like to express our satisfaction with the final destruction of the declared chemical weapons by the Federation, by Russian Federation. And we note that we will be reaching the ultimate goal of total destruction of declared chemical weapons stockpiles very shortly. We've also taken note of developments in the Syrian Arab Republic, and we would continue all stakeholders to continue with their efforts of dialogue between that state party and the technical secretary in order to implement and uphold the relative decisions that have been made in this area. area. We are deeply concerned by the recent reports of the JIM and FFM. We strongly condemn the use of chemical weapons in the Syrian Arab Republic, and those guilty should be brought to justice. My delegation regrets the fact that the members of the Executive Council haven't yet been able to come up with a final determination on this humanitarian crisis. The member states have to stand united inside the Council in order to strengthen the effectiveness and credibility of the organization. Mr. Chairman, we are now facing serious risks of chemicals being used by non-state actors or by terrorist groups. And this is not just a threat for countries in the Middle East, but for international peace and security. Education and outreach play a critical role in preventing this from happening again. The organization should step up its efforts in this area in the future. The Kingdom of Morocco is steadfast in its efforts to uphold its obligations under the Convention. We've adopted administrative and legislative measures set forth in Article 7 and that reflect the decisions that have been adopted by the Office of State Parties in past sessions. The different activities organized with the Technical Secretariat with certain state parties to the Convention, including Morocco, have made it possible for my country to build our national capacity, to share our experiences and expertise, and also to benefit from the best practices of others. The Kingdom of Morocco organized with the Technical Secretariat a basic course on assistance and protection in the event of chemical weapons attacks for the Arab states parties. This was held in Casablanca in May. Morocco believes that these events are always very useful, and that's why we offer hosting an annual assistance and protection coordination workshop in Marrakesh in 2018. Mr. Chairman, once we've put the destruction of chemical weapons behind us, we must focus on the peaceful uses of chemicals. As part of this, we need to step up determined international cooperation pursuant to Article 10. This is something that could mobilize all of our efforts. And when I speak about the role of chemistry, and even more so, green chemistry, industrial and sustainable development is very important. It's of utmost importance for the economic and technological development of all the countries that are members of the organization. We believe that this 20th anniversary of the organization is the ideal time for us, first of all, to reiterate our deep attachment to the principles and objectives of the Convention and to band together to face the challenges of the proliferation and the threat of resurgence of chemical weapons. Chairman, I would greatly appreciate it if this statement could be considered an official document of the conference. Thank you for your attention.